Welcome students for the civil engineering department. So I, Professor Ravi B. Tilaganji, as Professor R. B. Tilaganji from Department of Civil Engineering, AITM, Belgaum, going to give you a lecture as a teacher for the subject 18 CV 32 with a scheme of 18, which was established in the 2018 year, subject name with strength of materials. Now, for a small kind, strength of materials, any material which is existed on the earth is having some or the other kind of strength. We are able to see hard wood is also having a strength. Steel is having also a strength, rubber is also having a strength, rod is also having a strength, even our own hair is also having a small kind of strength. So these strength of materials we are going to deal in this subject. So let us see what is the in detail syllabus of the subject strength of materials. Details of syllabus. So the syllabus comprises of 5 modules. Module 1, simple stress and strain. Module 2, compound stresses, thin and thick cylinders. Module 3, shear force and bending moment in beams. Module 4, bending and shear stresses in beams, torsion in circular shaft. Module 5, deflection of beams, columns and struts. So the syllabus is bifurcated into 5 modules, and these modules will be covered in this syllabus of strength of materials. So what will be the part of thing we are going to study in detail? So I'll be telling you regarding every module brief, what will be there, what thing we have to remember when we are entering into this part of module, how we have to tackle the things which are coming as one of the knowledge and obstructions, where we will rise our knowledge step one above another. Such things will be dealt in each of the modules, and purely we have to get into the syllabus, we need something called as imagination. In sense, I used to say this as a third eye of our own, means with only these two eyes we are not able to see the thing which is behind the screen. The thing which is behind the screen, that we have to imagine. To imagine, we have to connect into our minds. So please listen, module 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be dealt in detail as per the videos. So let us see what will be the syllabus. Module 1, simple stress and strain. So we will be having a definition and concept related to stress and strain. Stress and strain, when we see into the word itself, we will come to say that stress means someone is giving you some work. Example, take you. I'll be making that things. You are going to have some relaxing moment in the home, and suddenly
your parents or your siblings, someone will come and make you something which is not interested for you. Then you will come see that this person or this thing is going to give me a stress. After you complete that part, some of your body starts paining. Some of things or wherever you are going for things, you will pick up something heavy material. Later, once you are releasing that heavy material or you are taking it one place to another place, after some time, your some of the hand will start paining, or if you have taken it on your shoulder will start paining, or after your exercise, your body needs some rest. So these type of things are called as strain. Similarly, how the human body is going to have some stress and strain, even the non-living thing means the body which is not having blood and heart is also having stress and strain. Hooke's law. Something, a law is there which we are going to take into account. This we will take how the stress and strain are related with Hooke's law. Then comes stress strain diagrams for ferrous and non-ferrous materials. So there are n number of materials near us, surrounding to us. We have iron, which is called as ferrous material. We have the another part or another type of iron that is again called as a ferrous material. We have wood, we have glass, we have eraser, which are known as non-ferrous materials. So these all parts are of the things where we will deal how stress and strain diagrams. Why stress and strain diagrams are required? Things, how they are going to behave under some loads which are not developed internally, the loads which are developed externally on them. Loads which are developed externally on them means, if we take a nail, we want to place it into wall, and to place that nail into wall, we are hammering it on its head with the hammer. Suddenly the nail slips down and hammer head comes on our finger. What happens to our finger? It have a small amount of crush, or it may bleed if the hammer speed is more, and there we will analyze that it is having a sudden load on that. Though we have removed it, again it is reacting, because that moment the load which is acting on that particular finger is more. Finger is trying to recall its original state. Finger is trying to come on its original shape and size. That is where it is giving internal resistance, which is relating when the external force was acting on it. It starts reacting that way. Now, some other things, elongation of different types of bars. Different types of bars means, simple way I can say that, bars we always have seen them in circular, or some of the solid bars in square shape. We also have seen some bars which are of circular shape but tapered from one and other end. One end the diameter is very small, another end the diameter is very large. Means larger diameter to smaller diameter the bar is connected. This may be of a steel or anything. The elongation is going to take place in this type of bars, or the bar is trapezoidal. Trapezoidal means we are having it as in the shape of V shape. That way, elongation under the self weight. When elongation under the self weight means, if we just sit on some of the elevated place and we leave our legs down, we feel that something is pulling us in the downward direction. It is pulled by gravitational force. The pull which is taking by the gravitational force will act some elongation on our legs. That is called as elongation under the self weight. Another principle comes as Saint Venant's principle, where we are going to use this Venant's principle and which part we are going to see with this. Compound bars and temperature stresses. Compound bars means in construction or in mechanical, we have seen some of the bars are connected with some other shape. Rectangle is connected with circular, circular is connected with trapezoidal, trapezoidal is connected with again varying diameter, or somewhere the thickness is more, somewhere the thickness is less, like that. Those are called as compound bars. We can also see the doors. Doors panel is joined with the frame. Frame size is somewhat and the panel of the door is somewhat else. Size is something else. That way. So that type of things we have seen earlier also, but now we are considering them for our study. Temperature stresses. Temperature stresses means, simple way, temperature. If temperature rises, what happens? Temperature rises means body starts getting increase the temperature. Or summer season and rainy season, the best comparison. In summer season, we feel very much humid, hot. Outside air is very much hot. And in rainy season, we feel it's very chill. Chill. Something we should have sitting in home, a hot things. Elastic constants and their relationships. There are some elastic constants which are related with respect to stress strain diagrams. Those elastic constants are again having some of the relationships, such as Young's modulus is there, bulk modulus is there, modulus of rigidity is there. So these all are the elastic constants which will be interrelated relationships. Also, module 1 is comprising of problems. This module 1 is of problematic part. We are dealing maximum of 60% of problems in the whole subject. 40% out of 40%, 20% are the derivations and 20% are the theoretical part, such as remembering formulas, remembering definitions. So everything will be dealt in a clear picture, clear view, what we want to do as per the syllabus, beyond the syllabus also what we are going to do. Clear? So moving to module number 2. Compound stresses, thin and thick cylinders. So as we have studied compound stresses with respect to compound bars. So compound bars, there only bar connections were there in module 1. Here stresses are also compound. Stresses are also compound means either the stresses are acting in 2-dimensional, 3-dimensional, how they are acting. Module 1, what is stress? Acting in only one direction. Then coming to module 2, stresses are in compound directions. Compound directions means simple way. Example, assume that you are on a seashore, very good atmosphere, surrounding all are playing, everyone is there. So, as a small children, we all start digging the sand which is near the seashore. Then we will put our leg into it. We will again close that part and tighten that particular sand. We will ask some of our relatives or friends, to tighten it, totally you tighten it, so that I could not able to remove my hand or leg from that particular pit. So that time we realize some of the forces are acting on our leg surfaces. That type of forces, they are creating something on our body. Our body starts small reactions in all the direction. That is called as compound stresses. Stress at a point. At one point you are going to take a stress. At one point means when we take a pen and we place it on a paper. So that paper is taking that pen needle stress. That is known as stress at a point. Two dimensional, one is acting in x direction, one is acting in y direction. More circle of stress. So we are going to deal with the stress. When the more circle which will relate with minimum amount of stress, maximum amount of stress, and one is average stress. So this we will draw with reference to two-dimensional stress system. Shear stress theory and maximum principle stress theory. So here two theories are there. How shear stress is there, how principal stress is there. Shear means we are going to tear a paper. When we hold the paper and we will tear it into two pieces, that is called as shearing. Then comes thick and thin cylinders, the things which are most important nowadays. We have a cylinder, then only we are able to prepare our food. So those cylinders will have some of the pressures. Which type of pressures? Hoop stresses, longitudinal stresses. Hoop stresses or longitudinal stresses. Longitudinal stresses, lengthwise it is acting. Hoop stresses, it is acting diametrical. One equation for the thick cylinders we are going to use as Lemmas equation, where we are going to find out radial and hoop stress distribution. We are going to determine radial and hoop stress distribution. So small formulas are there, and those formulas we are going to use them as a numericals. So here again 60-40, same 20 bifurcation and 60. Module 3, shear force and bending moments in beams. Before going to beam, I'll come to human body. Human body means shearing. When we meet with an accident somewhere on the road, suddenly our skin gets torn out. That is the cut mark on the skin is called as shear. So it is scratched totally out, two pieces. Or suddenly one of our hand got bended because of some of the kind of loading, or our hand, leg, the joints got dislocated. Bending was there, moment was not acting reactive, it came out of the joint. So that is bending moment. So these way the flexibility is there in our hand. We can change it in any direction, but the flexibility is not present in the beams. These are the horizontal members which are provided in the structure to carry the loads from the slab and transfer that load to the columns, as you all have studied this in your first year engineering mechanics as support reactions. Now, types of beams. How many types of beams you have studied there? You have studied simply supported. Two supports are there, simply supported. How many types of supports are there? How many types of loadings were there? Those all will come into account, such as beams. Simply supported beam, cantilever beam, overhanging beam, continuous beam, deep beam, propped cantilever beam supports, simply supported cantilever, fixed, pinned, continuous supports, loadings, point load, couple, varying load, uniformly distributed load, or combination of all. Bending moment and shear force, sign conventions and relationship. So bending moment and shear force means one force is acting in upward direction, one force is acting in downward direction. Bending moment, one moment is acting in clockwise direction, one moment is acting in anti-clockwise direction. So when we come across these type of things, we have to go with some of the sign conventions. Which one we will consider it as positive, which one we will consider it as negative, and how both bending and shear force are interrelated this time. Then shear force and bending moment for statically determinate beams. Shear force and bending moment for statically determinate beams means the beams which are able to resolve or find out the forces which are acting on the beams only when these beams are having three unknowns, not more than three unknowns, such as in x direction one unknown, in y direction one unknown, and one rotational unknown, like that. So those are called as statically determinate beams. Loading conditions. So early here, types of loadings I have cleared: point loads, uniformly distributed loads, uniformly varying loads, couple, and their combinations will be the numericals on shear force and bending moment. Moving to module number 4, bending and shear stress in beams, torsion of circular shaft. Pure bending, the beams which are acting with the loads are only having the pure bending. Pure bending means stress will not be there, shearing will not be there, only the beam will go under bending. So now which of the structure will go under bending? If we take a natural part, which structure will go under bending? We can see PVC pipe, which can easily have a bend. Also we can see bamboo, which can easily have a bending. Plastic, some kind of easily bending, because some are hard plastic, they get broken into two pieces, not that type of. Then what is the bending equation? Bending equation is M by I, E by R, F by Y. I repeat, M by I, M divided by I is equals to E divided by R is equals to F divided by Y. What is M? Moment. Moment itself is M. I, moment of inertia. Moment of inertia, where we have studied in first year mechanics, moment of inertia was one topic. So that moment of inertia again comes into account. So we have to remember what all is the moment of inertia and all things. Bending equation, F. F is what? Stress. How much force is acting on that? E, Young's modulus. R, radius of curvature. Y is again the distance of centroid of that particular point. So which point we want? That distance from the particular support or from the particular surface. Modulus of rupture is also same. Section modulus, flexural rigidity. Again the combination and relationship between them. So bending stress and shear stress distribution diagrams for circular rectangular I section and T sections we are going to take into this module as a numerical and as a graphical. Graphical means we are going to draw some diagrams as a stress diagram, how much amount of stress is there, how much amount of stress is there at a joint, like that. Pure torsion, as we have seen pure bending, same way something is there in the torsion. Torsion means what? Torsion means twisting. When we see, we have to remove the water from the wet cloth such that it gets dry at very faster rate and at very early time. We will twist that particular wet cloth to remove the water which is in that. That is called as pure torsion. So we will consider torsion equation for circular shafts, torsional rigidity and polar modulus, and power transmitted by the shaft. So power transmitted by the shaft means when we are twisting the wet cloth, how much amount of twist we are providing in rotational direction, that we are going to consider. So this rotation part we have studied in our kinematics, that is angular displacement or rotational displacement. There we have considered in first year mechanics. Moving to module number 5, deflection of beams, columns and struts. Deflection definition, we are going to find out of a slope. So when any body is going to have a small deflection, so from that deflection we will get a small amount of a slope. Means it is usually first in a horizontal direction, then some loading is acting on that particular horizontal member, suddenly it will have a small amount of a deflection. Small amount of a deflection, if we draw a tangent from that particular deflected bottom surface, that tangent will show small angle, that angle we will see it as a slope. Deflection and curvature, again same thing. Then derivation for the moment curvature equation. Then we will see double integration method and Mackle's method, slope and deflection, to determine slope and deflection for standard loading cases, for the determinate prismatic beams subjected to only point loads, UDL, UVL and couple, none other than that. Then we will come for columns and struts. So we will have a comparison, what is short column, what is long column. So to have an analysis of columns, we are having some Euler's theory, a person who derived some theory to determine some of the deflections in columns. Columns is what? As I mentioned, in beam section, beam is a horizontal member, column is a vertical member which takes loads from beams and transfers the loads to the foundation so that structure is safely standing on the ground. Then buckling. So if we take a small pen refill, anyhow it is a flexible part, we try to apply force on the two tips, you can try it. We are going to apply a force on the two tip. When we apply the force, the refill will start bending in some or the other direction, which is called as buckling. It is not called as bending when it is in vertical direction, it is known as buckling. So there will be a buckle when it is having support in different conditions. So that is nothing but different end conditions. So how the support will be? Somewhere it will be fixed, somewhere it will be free, somewhere the supports are rollers, somewhere the supports are hinged, like that. So buckling will be different for every different conditions. And limitations of Euler's theory, Rankine's Jordan formula for columns. Then last part of the thing is, to understand this part of subject, we need to find out what is the prerequisite. In the sense, we have to remember what all we have studied in first year mechanics. So in first year mechanics, I'll recall in some moment. First, for engineering mechanics, we understood what is force, how the force is resolved into the required x direction and y direction, how the rotational is considered on a body, rotational force known as a couple or as a moment, or the force is acting at some point, we are considering at some other point, resolving it at that particular point. Those all are the part of forces which are considered in this subject. So we will consider point loads, uniformly distributed loads, uniformly varying loads, couples. So when it comes uniformly distributed loads, how we are going to transfer that uniformly distributed load into point load, free body diagram. So free body diagram we have to take into consideration. Uniformly varying load, one side it will be a small amount of load, another side it will be a large amount of load, or one side it is zero, another side there is a load. That distribution is there as a uniformly varying load. This part we have to again resolve into another condition. This will be considered. So these all already we have studied, but something we have to remember from that and we have to apply in this subject. Then the speed of solutions will be very easy for us. Then comes, we have to remember some properties. How to determine the center of gravity? Center of gravity means x bar and y bar, which we have determined. How to determine the moment of inertia of the regular shapes? Regular shapes, moment of inertia, such as rectangular, BD cube by 12. Square, it is also same, d raised to 4 by 12. Triangle, there one more formula is there. There two formulas are also acting, one at the central level, one at the base level. Circular, one at the diametrical axis, one at the radial axis or circumferential axis. Semicircle, quarter circle, moment of inertia formulas are there. We have determined some formulas in engineering mechanics. Those formulas we will consider. Supports are there, support types. We will consider the supports, types of beams, types of loadings, support reactions. Main thing, the reactions, how we determined in the support reactions. So support reactions will be here in module number 3. This part, shear force and bending moment. So the shear force itself will give the, will be determined by the support reactions, what we are going to find, how we have determined them in our first year engineering mechanics. Sign convention same, upward positive, downward negative, clockwise positive, anti-clockwise negative. So this prerequisite, so means these knowledge we have to refresh. You have to repeat those things, write down in somewhere, try to recall them, mug up the formulas so that that you are going to use in this subject. We have also taken equilibrium forces. Those equilibrium forces such as summation f of y, summation f of x, summation m, we will consider here also. Summation x, summation y, summation m. There, why we were considering only what is summation x, what is summation y, what is summation m, why we are considering that as 0. That part it is summation x equal to 0, summation y equal to 0, summation m equal to 0. In that way, we have to consider, and that duration will be also considering for determining shear force and bending moment of the beams. So, determining the part of problems will be very easy if we are in touch with the previous subject theoretical numerical problems. We have to understand the previous formulas, remember them, and continue to solve with that as a basics. So this way we will be having the total subject known as strength of materials, all the strength, how the body will take the strength. This subject is again related to one of the similar practical in this semester only, which will be again taught by me only. Building materials testing laboratory. So whatever the stress strain curve are taught here, same we will use in the practical also. Here we will stick on to small values, in lab we will stick on to the detailed values, how we are able to get them. So this was the subject details, syllabus details. After learning all these 5 modules, what you are going to get? Question may be there. It is a genuine part. What you will get after learning this course, after learning this subject? So course and subject, both are same. So which course? Strength of materials is the course. So this you are going to learn. What are the course outcomes? You will be able to analyze the circular, rectangular and taper bars for stress strain, the materials using St. Venant's theory. Analyze the thin and thick cylinders for stresses such as hoop stress, longitudinal stress, internal external pressure,
using Lamy's theorem. Analyze the determinate beam for shear force and bending moment subjected to loads, point loads, uniformly distributed loads, uniformly varying loads, couples and combination of loads. Analyze the beams for bending and shear stress. Analyze the circular shafts for torsional effects. Analyze deflection of beams using double integration method and Michaelis method. Analyze to column and strut using Euler's equation and Rankine-Jordan formula. So don't have a fear that analyze means a mathematical will be there and you don't think that you are weak in mathematics. Think that it's very easy part. You don't want to remember the things. Only go on practicing the things. Only go on practicing. Try to solve the number of problems, the same problems, 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time, 5 time, 6 time. 7th time, definitely it will be coming without studying the same problem. Only things, understand the small basics which we are using in this. So, this was the detailed syllabus of 18CV32 Strength of Materials for Civil Engineering 3rd semester. So, welcome for 3rd semester. Thank you. See you in the next video. Goodbye.